All right. So if you need to do different currencies for an a program, a product that you're selling, for right now, Kajabi does not have different currencies or multiple currencies on one offer checkout page. So I'm going to walk you through how you can currently do it. They are making huge changes to the offer checkout pages, so this video could change in the next couple of months, but currently this is how you would do it. So we will write in currency offer. We'll do it as US dollars. We'll do it as whatever the product is. You can always change that, so don't worry about that, especially if you don't have your product done and it doesn't show up in the list. Then you want to click on edit the price. We'll make it a one-time payment. We'll make it nice, easy numbers, $50, and we'll have it be US currency. We'll click save. Obviously, you will customize the rest of the offer the way that you need. Then we'll do another offer. So we're going to create another offer. And this one will be currency offer UK. And we'll click save. Again, it would be for the same product. Then we'll click edit the price, make it one-time payment, make it 50, and then go over here and we will choose, let's see. I've never had to look up the UK price. I'm gonna, let's see, is it GR? Is it the pound? Let's see. British pound. Yep, there we go. So we'll do that and we'll click save. All right. Then we'll click, double click that, save again. Now that we have both of the offers created, what you wanna do is we're gonna click get the link. Because we're right here on the British price. And then we're going to close that out. We're going to go back to offers. We're going to find the USD price. We're going to open this up. Then where it says edit checkout, I want you to click on that. Here underneath offer details, all right, you can put down here. And you could put it in bold, to pay in, and I apologize if I'm saying this wrong, British pound, click here. Then you're going to highlight that, click the link, put in the offer that was the British pound, and click OK. We're going to click save. We're going to have it open in a new window. So this, again, it is a workaround. This is how it currently works. So you have this, and obviously you'd have your other information, but this is, would say $50, but then you could have to pay in the British pound, click here. You could also list another payment if you did have three payment options to pay in, only because I know what Japanese is called. I could do that. And obviously, I'd need a third offer page. So that is how you could list the different currencies. Now we need to go back to the offers and get the US dollar. Okay, we need to get that link so that we can put it on the UK page. So we're going to copy the link for the US. And then we are going to go back to the British pound right here. We're going to click edit checkout. We're going to click on offer details. And the nice thing about this, even though it is a workaround, that as soon if Kajabi makes a change so that it really is a matter of clicking a button and having different currencies that you select appear, all you haven't hard coded anything. All you have to do is go in and take out the checkout copy. So it's a really easy update when and if, because I'm not positive that the multiple currencies is an option in the new development cycle, but they are making huge foundational, like structural changes to the offers. Then on, now you have both of these URLs. You can put those URLs, you can either have, if you use the Kajabi website determined sales pages, meaning whatever website is active on your site, even if you're not using it for a site, that this will show up. So if I do this, we'll call it multiple currency offerings. And we're not going to mess with any of this. We're just going to click save. The Kajabi sales pages that are determined by website, those are what automatically pull into your Kajabi store if you're using that. So I will add the UK and I will add the US dollar. Now, if I want to, on this sales page, both of these will show. So if I copy the sales page and we'll put it up here, we'll open up a new window. We'll take a look at it. It will show, bye-bye, the different pricing options. So this, you can have this so that it's on the Kajabi website determined sales pages. Both offers with the different currencies will list. If I click purchase offer right here, this is where you see the text that we created. If I click, oh, yep, I would rather pay in the British pound, I click there, it takes me to this offer. So that is how you can line them up on this same sales page when you're using Kajabi sales pages. If instead you're using a landing page as your sales page, then you can put it anywhere there is a, no, we'll use this page, anywhere that a call to action button exists, and I will add, we'll show you on this page. This is just an opt-in page, but I want you to, the call to action is the same no matter where you are. Here, when I click on a call to action, I can have it go to a sales page. That means the Kajabi website determined sales pages, or I could have it go to a checkout page. If I have it go to a checkout page, I can choose the currency offer I want, have it open in a new window, and have this be currency UK like that. So we'll click save. And again, it's going to be wherever you put the call to action, but it's right there. Okay. And then you could add a call to action and put the US dollar amount. So I hope that gives you an idea of how you could handle different currencies right now. If you have any questions, please add them in the comments below. I'm glad to help. And as Kajabi continues to roll out the new features and the updates for the offer checkout page, this could very well change in the next few months. So, again, easy to undo that text and just start using whatever Kajabi builds if they do. But this way you can currently offer dual currency just by using the functionality of this site. Have a great day, and I will talk to you guys soon. Bye-bye.